Happy New Year. We sent the year of 2020 into the past, and we welcome New Year. The year of 2021 is crawling and coming here, and we are looking at the first Sunday of the year. What a wonderful. Even though there was no fireworks, there was no shouting celebration, in this calm and serenity, a new year came to us. Whether it be due to the ongoing war with the COVID-19, the streets were empty. And there were no noisy fireworks, no shouting crowds. Regardless, the new year is still dawned upon us. While quietly meditating on the new year, I prepared today's message in the title of New Wine in Fresh Wineskins. Whenever I read the Bible, I realized the Bible is filled with the things anew. Of those, the greatest is God's creation. For once, there was nothing but emptiness. And then there was the Word of God. For God's Word created something from nothing. Ex nihilo, creatio ex nihilo, creation from nothing, vukuon. And continue to create something from something, continual creation. God continues to make things anew. So our task is to give ourselves up to the newness that God brings with the creation. God's creation is still going on, doesn't never stop at all. Psychoanalyst Wilfred Vion calls upon us to be without memory or desire. For our memories speak of the past, while our desires speak for our future. To be without past or future means that we need to be focused on the present and be present. To live life anew means to cast away the past, not be caught up by the future, but to be present and live in each moment. Science states that the history of the universe began at a certain point, and that the moving cosmos will come to stop at another. As you know, the genius physicist Stephen Hawking defined time beginning with the Big Bang, existing as the universe expanded, and the history of the universe would come to an end when the universe expands, it would cease and start contracting until it returned to a certain point. In between, we call it time. According to another scientific theory, the universe could continue expanding until it would vanish into ash. Of course, there are countless worlds beyond the tiny scope of the universe that we bear witness to, as well as many more ash-like dying worlds from our point in time. The end of the universe is rather bleak, as is predicted as either ending in one point or ash. Yet the scripture, the word of God, proclaims that creation and life transcend time itself. not from the past, but from the Word of God, something truly eternal from the future, is where life came. Theologian Ted Peters declares that God is the future of the world. Newness and creation comes from the future. It comes from the Word of God. The Word of God created the world. That very Word saved us as new beings. And the Word makes the church we are gathered together in anew all the time. Today's Word speaks to us. Put new wine into fresh wineskins. Jesus knew that his words were too revolutionary. I prefer to say this, his word was too radical and new to the people of the world listening to him. Particularly how different his teachings were compared to the traditional teachings of the Jewish Orthodox rabbis. He also knew how difficult it would be for people to take in his word and start his lives anew. And so he used today's scripture to describe how life in the kingdom of God that had already begun to manifest in entirely new order, completely different from the world before. Jesus speaks of that over there, with that which is here. He speaks of the kingdom of God with the things of the earth. We call it parable or metaphor. The moving force of the kingdom of God and its power and ability is truly great. Like a new wine, it will burst if put into new wineskins. New wine requires new wineskins. The Lord not only granted us the good news as a new wine, but also a new wineskin to contain it in. During the Middle Ages, the corrupt Roman Catholic Church couldn't contain the good news of God. God created a new wineskin through Martin Luther. The Anglican Church of England in the 18th century couldn't contain the new wine. Thus, it was poured into the new wineskin that was John Wesley, the birth of the Methodist Church today. We need to take a hard look at if our church too is able to contain the kingdom of God. If not, we need to prepare new wineskins. The Lord borrowed the lips of the Apostle Paul and spoke, "So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new." In the new year, we are called to become new wineskins, able to contain the good news and the kingdom of God. Wine was kept in wineskins, as there were no bottles as we have today. A new wineskin may boast impressive elasticity. So flexible, soft, and endure to any pressure. But over time, this new wineskin, as time goes on, it becomes old and hard. eventually losing its elasticity, losing its the power of flexibility. New wine is still ongoing, the fermentation process. So it is exuding gases. A new wine skin can absorb the pressure from these gases. Yet an old wine skin is hardened and can bust if filled with new wine, which will result in losing both the wine and the wine skin. Jesus told us that our hearts need to become anew. If our hearts are stubborn, enjoy in asserting and being set on fixed ideas, ideologies, then it is similar to an old wineskin. It cannot contain new change nor truth of a new age. Physically alive, externally okay, but mentally, spiritually dead. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. The birth of something new means that the things of the past have passed. Looking to nature, the flow of life continues naturally. Plants sprout, leaves and fruit grow, then leaves shed. The plant is left bare to the roots to endure through the winter. Yet as time passes by, the roots grow new sprouts, alerting all that is still bears life. So too is the history of the gospel. What was old passed away, and everything become new. The ways and traditions of the past need to become new in the present. For God is the force that makes all things new. Salvation has made the present now among us through eternal God. The history of a new creation is made by God, the future and eternity of the world, the present within us and among us in the community. New wine is the Spirit of God. The true life come within us. That is the imminent kingdom of God of the heavens. The Holy Spirit makes the field of our hearts into new wineskins that can contain the kingdom of God. The Zhongdong English Ministry is the continuation of the new. Leaders come and go. Members change. But the one who leads this ministry of a new history is our Lord. Our task is to align ourselves to God's history of life. We Christians have no authority to declare where they should go or where we should go. For God is the one who determines that. God, who made us, touched us, and saved us, also decides for us. Abraham knew not where he should go, but follow the Lord's guidance. When Jacob was at his deathbed, in faith did it bless each of Joseph's sons and held his step and stood to worship God. He did not live settled and fixed to a certain mindset, but lived a life as a pilgrim. That is our destiny. We are pilgrims. Our task is to hear and follow the voice of God. That is obedience. For the Bible demands obedience over any form of offering. Obedience comes from the Latin word audire, which means listen. To listen to the word of God is obedience. Obedience is to listen and follow the absolute authority of the word of God. God has the word to be fulfilled through the Zhongdong English Ministry. Serving in the Zhongdong English Ministry, I came to realize and I came to hear of God's overjoyed will for us. This is the vision of all peoples being together from all nations. And the visions of all peoples from all ages, colors, genders, and nations come before the Lord in praise and worship to serve the world. Therefore, our English ministry is not just a male or female, Jew or Gentile, although to a child, but it confesses that we are one in God. To establish such a radical, equal community on this earth is both the vision and promise of God for the English ministry here in Zhongdong. Dearly my beloved, keep the word of God in your heart. For Zhongdong EM has been raised as a ministry for all the people of the world to come together. We have been called to build up this ministry. May you and me, may we all obey this holy promise of God, regardless of the times changing, leaders coming and going. The owner and author of our ministry is our God. Also, listen to the word spoken by the Lord. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. Those who shall take part in the new history are taught to renew our minds. To renew one's mind is to take on the heart of God. For the heart of God is not one that critiques and nor teaches. The heart of God is the love-filled heart of the mother and heart of the father. The Bible tells us, rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Pray without ceasing, which means that we should pray with each breath, that we should pray with our lives, and that we should pray until we die. Rejoice always means that we need a lot of patience in life, that we should endure difficult moments and times of suffering. To the member and community that can endure and be patient, God grants the gift of joy. Remember, joy doesn't come to us without any endurance brings the joy to each of you. Give thanks in all circumstances, which means that we should take in all things as the word of God. That we should take in all tasks as worship offered up to God. In all circumstances, worshiping God is living a thankful life. As we endure through COVID-19, we came to see that things won't always be sunny and shiny in our lives. Close friends and relatives were lost to the illness. It's not others' story. Very near to us, our relatives and friends are losing their life. as we too live the long periods of our lives locked away at home, like in prison. There's much fear, especially for the elderly, and people health issues such as the related to breathing, that fear becoming exposed to the virus. The virtue we need in these difficult times is to endure well and also support each other, pray each other, exchange the word of consolation and comfort to each other. God will grant us the power to endure in each moment. I won't be setting some bold New Year's message for us. In this time of change, in this time of suffering, our task in the new year is to obey the history of God, of new wines being filled with new wineskins. I bless you to be filled with thanksgiving, joy, and prayer, even during these changing times of suffering. God makes things new. God is life. Not even winter, nor COVID-19 can stop the power of life. For God is life. I pray that the history of life be ever present and overflowing in our lives and ministries. I pray that our lives and thoughts and ministries be flexible as new wineskins. No matter what pressure, no matter what things are coming to us, be there. And God will give you the power to endure. May the blessing of God be upon you. Amen.